Hello everyone, welcome to Arpita Sharma classes. I am Arpita Sharma, your educator, and today we are going to decode the Hindu newspaper for 10th of July 2020. आप सभी का स्वागत है अर्पिता शर्मा क्लासेस में. आज हम 10th of July 2020 का हिंदू न्यूज़पेपर डिकोड करने जा रहे हैं. वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट करंट अफेयर्स फ्रॉम टुडेज न्यूज़पेपर. ऑल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व 6 क्वेश्चंस व्हिच केम इन प्रीलिम्स 2019. प्रीलिम्स 2019 के 6 क्वेश्चंस क्लास में सॉल्व करेंगे. डेली वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन पेपर सो दैट यू विल हैव एन आइडिया हाउ द यूपीएससी इज फ्रेमिंग क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम करंट अफेयर्स. एक तरीके से आपको रफ आइडिया मिल जाएगा कि आपको करंट अफेयर्स में कैसे क्या पढ़ना है, कैसे क्वेश्चंस फ्रेम होते हैं, ठीक है. और प्लस प्रैक्टिस भी हो जाएगी प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन पेपर्स की. क्लास नोट्स आर अपलोडेड ऑन माई टेलीग्राम चैनल, वहां से आप क्लास नोट्स देख सकते हो, ठीक है, डाउनलोड कर सकते हो. लेट्स स्टार्ट विदाउट एनी डिले. ऑल्सो आई एम टेकिंग लाइव क्लासेज ऑन अनअकैडमी प्लस, सो यू कैन सब्सक्राइब टू अनअकैडमी प्लस, गेट 10% डिस्काउंट बाय यूजिंग दिस रेफरल कोड शर्मा20. अनअकैडमी प्लस पे मैंने 2021 का जो बैच चल रहा है ना यूपीएससी का, उसमें एंशियंट और मिडिवल इंडियन हिस्ट्री की क्लासेज ली हुई हैं. तो वहां पर क्लासेस अभी चल रही हैं. आप चाहो तो 10% डिस्काउंट मिल रहा है, इस कोड को यूज करके आप सब्सक्राइब कर सकते हो. लेट्स स्टार्ट विद क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 बिफोर एनालाइजिंग द न्यूज़पेपर. विद रेफरेंस टू एशियन इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इन्वेस्टमेंट कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स. AIIB हैज मोर देन 80 मेंबर नेशंस. इंडिया इज द लार्जेस्ट शेयर होल्डर इन AIIB. AIIB डज नॉट हैव एनी मेंबर्स फ्रॉम आउटसाइड एशिया. Which statement is correct? कौन सा statement correct है? You have to read the statements carefully. Now, Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. It is often seen in the news. Often रहता ही. So you have to answer the question accordingly. ठीक है? You have 5 seconds time to answer this question because it's very easy. It came in 2019. बहुत ही easy question है. Correct answer to this question is. It is A. That is statement 1 is correct. Statement number 1 absolutely correct hai. Asian Infrastructure Bank. It has more than 80 member nations. Yes, it is correct. 57 to iske founding nations hi hai. Right? And now the members have increased to 97. Theek hai? 97 members are approved. Please write it down. Isko likh lijiye. 97 approved members hai isme. Right? And there are 27 prospective members. That means membership अभी pending है इनकी, ठीक है. So total आपके 100 से ऊपर ही है members, right? So this is very important for your prelims. Second point है कि India is the largest shareholder in AIIB. Now that is wrong. ये बिल्कुल गलत है. India largest shareholder AIIB में नहीं है. It is China, ठीक है. तो इधर आप लिख सकते हो it is China, not India. China is the largest contributor. It contributes around $50 billion. $50 billion contribute karta hai, right? It is half of the initial subscribed capital. So that is China, not India. So this statement is wrong. Theek hai? Next statement says AIIB does not have any members from outside Asia. Again, this is absolutely incorrect. Outside Asia bhi iske members hain, right? UK, France, Germany, Italy, Greece, Africa, Brazil, Lebanon, Armenia, right? So it has also members outside from outside Asia. So third statement is also wrong. Clear? Question number 2. What was the purpose of inter-creditor agreement signed by Indian banks and financial institutions recently? Now this is very very important. Ye bahut hi zyada important hai. Theek hai? 2019 mein news mein bhi raha hai. First, to lessen government of India's perennial burden of fiscal deficit and current account deficit, to support infrastructure project of central and state government, to act as independent regulator in case of applications for loans of rupees 50 crore or more, to aim at faster resolution of stressed assets of rupees 50 crore or more which are under consortium lending. You have 10 seconds time to answer the question. करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज, इस क्वेश्चन का करेक्ट आंसर है इट इज डी. डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. to aim at faster resolution of stressed asset of rupees 50 crore or more which are under consortium lending. ठीक है, so this is very very important. Total stress assets in the Indian banking sector, please write it down. Total जो stressed assets हैं हमारे Indian banking sector में, they are around rupees 16.30 lakh crore. इतने आपके total stressed assets हैं. Okay, and this RBI has launched this inter-creditor agreement. ठीक है, ये बहुत ही important agreement है. जितने भी NBFCs हैं, ठीक है, उनको ये agreement help करेगा. The aim, particular aim of this agreement is, so here inter-creditor agreement, as you can see, the aim of this agreement is resolution of loan accounts with a size of 50 crore and above that are under the control of group of lenders. And this agreement also says that if 66% of lenders by value agree to a resolution plan to, you know, pay off the loans, it would be binding on all the lenders. All the other lenders have to agree with the plan. But if the other lenders are not agreeing with the plan, that is the dissenting creditors will, however, have the option to sell their loans to other lenders at a discount of 15%. To liquidation value, or they can buy by paying 125% of the value. ठीक है, clear? Which is agreed under the debt resolution plan by the other lenders. So this is very important. ये बहुत ही important point है. Now the next important topic that you should understand is the Indian Banks Association, right? In this context, this is very important for the upcoming prelims 2020 or 2021, even 2022 examinations. It was established in 1946. The headquarters are in Mumbai, and it is a group of Association of Indian Banks and Financial Institutions. And the members are All India Financial Institutions, Public Sector Banks, Private Sector Banks, Foreign Banks, which are having offices in India, Cooperative Banks, and Regional Rural Banks. Okay, these are Regional Rural Banks, RRBs. Yeah, and the objective is strengthening development and coordination of the Indian banking system. That is the objective. Next question, the chairman of public sector banks are selected by Banks Board Bureau, Reserve Bank of India, Union Ministry of Finance, Management of Concerned Bank. Now which option is correct? You have 5 seconds time to answer the question. 5 second ka time hai aapke paas question answer karne ka, jaldi se answer kare. It's very easy, bahut hi easy question hai. Correct answer to this question is, इस question का correct answer है, it is A, that is Banks Board Bureau is the correct answer. All right. Now let's answer the next question. Consider the following statements. Petroleum and Natural Gas Regulatory Board is the first regulatory body set up by the Government of India. One of the tasks of PNGRB is to ensure competitive markets for gas. Appeals against decisions of PNGRB go before the appellate tribunals for electricity. Which statement is correct? Another very easy question. बहुत ही easy question है. ये news में आता ही रहता है. It's always in news. You can attempt it very easily. आपके पास 10 seconds का time है. फटाफट से इसको attempt कीजिए. Correct answer to this question is B. That is statement 2 and statement 3 are correct. Statement 1 is wrong. It is not the first regulatory body. It was formed in 2006. Okay. And it was constituted under the Petroleum and Natural Gas Regulatory Board Act. Clear everyone? Itna clear ho gaya sabko? So first statement is wrong. Second and third statement are absolutely correct. Now the next important news is government watching WHO alert on airborne spread of virus. Now this is important for GS paper 2, right? Now here in this news, continuing to rule out community transmission of COVID-19. In the country, the Union Health Ministry on Thursday said that it is closely watching the dynamic evolution of the virus situation in India, with the World Health Organization now indicating that the virus may be airborne. अब बेसिकली WHO इज इंडिकेटिंग दैट वायरस मे बी एयरबोर्न एंड दिस इज आफ्टर व्हेन द 230 साइंटिस्ट दे अर्स्ड WHO टू अपडेट इट्स गाइडेंस रिगार्डिंग द ट्रांसमिशन मोड ऑफ कोरोना वायरस राइट। 230 साइंटिस्ट ने एक रिसर्च पेपर भेजा है WHO के पास, उसमें ये कहा है कि जो वायरस है ये एयरबोर्न हो सकता है, तो उसके अकॉर्डिंग आपको आपके जो अपडेट्स हैं WHO को कोरोना वायरस से रिलेटेड वो आपको अपडेट्स थोड़े ऑल्टर करने पड़ेंगे। सो बेसिकली WHO इज ऑल्सो सेइंग दैट यस देर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ कोरोना वायरस बींग ट्रांसमिटेड वाया एयरबोन और एरोसोल ट्रांसमिशन। दीज आर दी टू पॉसिबिलिटीज राइट। दो पॉसिबिलिटीज हैं कि या तो एयरबोन ट्रांसमिशन हो सकता है कोरोना वायरस का या फिर एरोसोल ट्रांसमिशन हो सकता है। नाउ फर्स्ट लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज ड्रॉपलेट ट्रांसमिशन। ये समझते हैं कि ड्रॉपलेट ट्रांसमिशन क्या होता है राइट। दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द ड्रॉपलेट ट्रांसमिशन इट अकर्स व्हेन अ पर्सन इज विद इन 1 मीटर ऑफ द इन्फेक्टर। जो भी इन्फेक्टेड है वायरस से, अगर कोई इंसान उसके 1 मीटर तक के एरिया में है, who coughs or sneezes and so is exposing their mouth, nose or eyes to potentially infective respiratory droplets, this is the case of droplet transmission. ये आपका droplet transmission का case हो जाता है, because in that case droplets are very heavy and they can fall on the floor also, right? The next case can be of the airborne transmission. Now here, in this airborne transmission method, transmission via aerosols, which are smaller droplets, can take place, which can linger in the air for longer period of time before falling to the floor. So they can be transmitted to others over distances greater than 1 meter. Right? These are the two cases of transmissions, droplet transmission and the airborne transmission. Clear? ये बहुत important है, ये आपको पढ़ना ही पढ़ना है, इसको याद रखिएगा। WHO has acknowledged the emerging evidence for the airborne spread of the novel coronavirus. While previously it had said that the virus spreads only through droplet transmission, now there are possibilities that there is airborne transmission included in this virus. Next, very important news, PM CARES is separate from NDRF, says government. So the government is responding to a writ petition which is filed by NGO Center for PIL. That said, that contributions made to the PM CARES should be transferred entirely to NDRF. So a writ petition has been filed by an NGO and it says that whatever contributions, donations you are making to PM CARES, it should be included in the NDRF. It should be transferred to NDRF. So to this, the Ministry of Home Affairs defended in the Supreme Court the existence of PM CARES funds to receive the voluntary donations. Okay, and the Ministry of Home Affairs also outright rejected a plea to credit the amounts received by PM CARES for fighting COVID-19 into the NDRF. What is NDRF? It is National Disaster Response Fund. Okay, NDRF kya hota hai? N means National, D means Disaster, R means Response, F means Funds. That is NDRF. ठीक है, so MHA says that we cannot transfer the money received in PM CARES to NDRF because NDRF is separate. Funds like PM CARES, they are separate, different, distinct from NDRF. And because of that, separate provisions govern them. So we cannot transfer the money. All right. Now the next question, very very important from GS paper 2's perspective. ये आपके GS paper 2 के perspective से important है. ठीक है, तो चलो उसका समझते हैं क्या टॉपिक है, क्या न्यूज में है। सो हियर यू कैन सी इंडिया विल टेक अ डिसीजन ऑन वेदर टू इंक्लूड ऑस्ट्रेलिया इन द मालाबार एक्सरसाइज विद जापान एंड यूएस एट अ डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री मीटिंग अर्ली नेक्स्ट वीक अकॉर्डिंग टू अ डिफेंस सोर्स। सो हियर इंडिया इज गोइंग टू टेक डिसीजन कि हम जो मालाबार एक्सरसाइज जापान और यूएस के साथ करते हैं उसमें ऑस्ट्रेलिया को ऐड किया जाए या नहीं, शुड वी ऐड ऑस्ट्रेलिया इन दिस एक्सरसाइज। इंडिया इज गोइंग टू टेक द डिसीजन एंड इफ द डिसीजन इज टेकन, अगर मान लीजिए ये डिसीजन ले लिया जाता है राइट ओवर हियर, द डिसीजन इफ टेकन कुड ब्रिंग ऑल क्वाड कंट्रीज टुगेदर एज अ पार्ट ऑफ द एनुअल वॉर गेम्स। ये एनुअल वॉर एक्सरसाइज है और अगर हमने ये डिसीजन ले लिया, इफ वी इंक्लूड ऑस्ट्रेलिया, देन यू नो द ऑल द क्वाड कंट्रीज जापान यूएस इंडिया ऑस्ट्रेलिया, दीज आर द क्वाड्रिलेटरल कंट्रीज, सो ऑल दीज क्वाड कंट्रीज विल कम टुगेदर। Okay, and after years of reluctance, India said it was open to Australia's inclusion in the Malabar as an observer. तो ऐसा माना जा रहा है कि देखो पहले क्या था, हमने अभी तक observer के position पे Australia को include किया था इस exercise में, right? The general consensus is that Australia should join. राइट। अब फाइनली डिस्कशंस आर गोइंग ऑन, अभी डिस्कशन तो हो रहे हैं फाइनली इसके ऊपर, ठीक है। ऑल राइट, नाउ द मालाबार एक्सरसाइज वॉज डिलेड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस COVID-19 राइट नाउ, बट इट इज सेड दैट इट विल टेक प्लेस इन द एंड ऑफ 2020, ठीक है। सो फॉर प्रिलिम्स वी नीड टू स्टडी द मालाबार एक्सरसाइज, प्रिलिम्स के लिए ये एक्सरसाइज बहुत ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है। सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द मालाबार एक्सरसाइज, जब हम मालाबार एक्सरसाइज की बात करते हैं, इट इज एन एनुअल ट्राइलेटरल एक्सरसाइज बिटवीन इंडिया, जापान एंड यूएसए, विच इज कंडक्टेड ऑल्टरनेटिवली, इट इज कंडक्टेड ऑल्टरनेटिवली इन इंडियन एंड पैसिफिक ओशन। एंड व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ मालाबार एक्सरसाइज, इस पर्टिकुलर एक्सरसाइज के बैकग्राउंड की जब हम बात करें, इट बिगैन एज अ बायलेटरल एक्सरसाइज बिटवीन इंडिया एंड यूएस इन 1992, but in 2015 it was converted into a trilateral exercise by adding Japan. Australia has not been added so far, but it is being speculated that this year it will be added. So in 2017 Australia was added just as an observer nation. It did not participate in the exercise, it just observed the exercise. And in 2018 also it was not added, 2019 also it was not added. Other exercises between India and Australia are Aussie Index and Pitch Black. This is very important. And in 2019 in September, 23rd edition of Malabar exercise took place. So this you have to remember, India and Japan Defense Forces organize a series of bilateral exercise also. Shinyu Maitri, Jimex and Dharma Guardian. This is between India and Japan, important for prelims. And between India and USA, Yuddha Abhyas, again very important for prelims. All right. So this is the next important news, full play of IoT in design of new Telangana Secretariat. Again, very, very important news. IoT, question on IoT came in 2018 prelims. IoT ke upar question 2018 ke prelims mein aaya tha, toh aapko ye padhna hai. The proposed new Telangana Secretariat complex will see the full play of Internet of Things. Interiors as well as the exteriors of futuristic new complex have thermal sensors. Underline this. Isme thermal sensors honge over here and feature voice controlled lightning also. Thermal sensors will ensure light switch on automatically when someone walks into a room. Jaise aap room mein ghusoge, light automatically open up ho jayengi. They are switched off as you walk out. This is the thermal sensor. Again, very, very important for prelims. Pre ke liye ye bahut important hai. Theek hai? Clear? Now let us understand the Internet of Things. Internet of Things समझते हैं क्या होता है. So this is the chart through which you can understand the working of Internet of Things. Now basically when we look at Internet of Things, the first job it does is the device connection, right? You all know that devices are connected. For example, your remote is connected to your television set, right? Remotes are connected to air conditioners, right? So this is device connection. Then data sensing is the next step in Internet of Things. Data sensing means it captures data, sensors, through tags, data ko capture karta hai. Then data transport and access. When we talk about data transport and access, it means communication, right? It transmits the data. For example, your mobile phones, your handsets, right? Then comes data analytics, that is artificial intelligence, all right? Then data value defined by action, that means actionable intelligence, APIs, analysis to action. And then human value, smart applications, for example, your refrigerators, aapke jo refrigerators hote hain, wo aapka human value mein aa jayega, theek hai, smart applications aa jayenge, right? These are the examples, right? So this is Internet of Things. Through internet, the objects are connected to each other. That is Internet of Things. For example, आपका mobile phone है, आपने एक button press किया और वहाँ पर AC on हो गया, आपने एक button press किया और coffee maker start हो गया, तो ये आपकी connectivity Internet of Things के वजह से है, ठीक है? So what is Internet of Things? It is a computing concept. Please write it down. इसको please लिख लीजिए. It's a computing concept that describes the idea of everyday physical objects being connected टू द इंटरनेट. ठीक है, क्लियर. इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज एन ऑब्जेक्ट दैट कैन रिप्रेजेंट इटसेल्फ डिजिटली बिकम्स समथिंग ग्रेटर देन द ऑब्जेक्ट बाय इटसेल्फ, राइट. दैट इज इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स. नाउ लेट्स सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. विद रेफरेंस टू कम्युनिकेशन टेक्नोलॉजीज, what is or are the difference or differences between long term evolution and voice over long term evolution? LTE is commonly marketed as 3G and VoLTE is commonly marketed as advanced 3G. LTE is data only technology and VoLTE is voice only technology. Which statement is correct? Kaun sa statement correct hai? You have 10 seconds of time to answer this question. 10 second ka time hai question answer karne ka. करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज डी, दैट इज नन ऑफ द अबव आर करेक्ट. दोनों ही गलत हैं. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स इज और आर करेक्ट रिगार्डिंग मटर्निटी बेनिफिट अमेंडमेंट एक्ट ऑफ 2017? अगेन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. प्रेग्नेंट वुमेन आर एंटाइटल्ड टू 3 months प्री डिलीवरी एंड 3 months पोस्ट डिलीवरी पेड लीव. Enterprise with creches must allow the mother minimum 6 creche visit daily. Women with 2 children get reduced entitlements. Which statement is correct? Jaldi se bataein. Kaun sa statement correct hai? Correct answer to this question is, इस क्वेश्चन का करेक्ट आंसर है, इट इज सी, दैट इज ओनली थर्ड स्टेटमेंट इज करेक्ट. द मटर्निटी बेनिफिट एक्ट 2017 प्रोवाइड्स फॉर 26 वीक्स ऑफ पेड मटर्निटी लीव फॉर वुमेन एम्प्लॉइज एंड वुमेन हु आर एक्सपेक्टिंग आफ्टर हैविंग 2 चिल्ड्रन दे गेट 12 वीक्स पेड मटर्निटी लीव एंड द मटर्निटी लीव कुड बी अवेल्ड 8 वीक्स बिफोर द एक्सपेक्टेड डेट ऑफ डिलीवरी. ठीक है, क्लियर. Secondly, the Act mandates for establishing of the creche facility at organizations who are employing 50 or more employees. ठीक है, clear? And the women employees are permitted to visit the creche facility 4 times during the day. ठीक है? So correct answer is third statement is correct. So you will get the PDF of the class on my Telegram channel. I hope you enjoyed today's class. Do not forget to share the video, subscribe to the channel, and also like the video. Thank you.